Hi guys, welcome back to Chess the Matthew. So on this video, we will tackle about the game 8 of Ian Nepomniachtchi versus Ding Liren of their clashes before their World Championship match 2023. So here, Nepo is white and he play another e4 move. And here, Ding Liren play the move e5 as black. Instead of his previous openings that he reply with the move e6, the French defense, against the e4 move of Nepo. So here after e4, e5, knight f3, knight c6 for Ding Liren. Nepo here plays d4, and after it takes d4, knight takes d4, and bishop c5, we shall reach on this position about the opening of the Scotch game. So here Nepo play the move knight takes to c6, capturing the knight and with an attack to the queen on d8. So Ding Liren here reply with the move b takes c6, in which this moves actually just put himself on the position with three islands, rather than for example after this knight takes c6, in which Ding Liren here can actually play the popular queen f6 move that with a threat to mate in one with the bishop and his queen. And if, for example, if the white here plays the move e3, then there is just a capture, doubling the e-pawn, and later on to recapture the knight on c6. So, for example, after the moves queen f3, d takes c6, knight c3, bishop e6, bishop e3, queen takes, g takes f3, bishop takes f3, f takes f3, and castle. And we shall see this position now that it puts on the white with three islands, and here we shall see that the black here has a slight advantage having a king castle, but with the absence of queen, still the position is unclear and rather than a draw. So after the moves knight takes c6, b takes c6, here Nepo play the move bishop d3, and after d6 opening some diagonal for his bishop, and Nepo here plays h3 first instead of castling right away. And after knight e7, knight c3, just a normal developing moves, knight g6 trying to reroute and to control the center, knight e4 trying to triple the c file, and after bishop d4 saving his bishop, c3 attacking the bishop, bishop f6 castle, e5 trying to win the bishop pair. So Nepo here preserve his bishop, castle for Ding Liren, f4 attacking the knight, and after knight d7, queen c2, c5, bishop f3 with an idea of opening some diagonal to attack both the queen and the bishop on f6. So Ding Liren here sidestep his rook to avoid this trick, and after bishop e3 completing the development of white, and after bishop a6 attacking the rook, the rook's move, queen e7 completing the development for the black perspective, bishop f2, bishop b5, rook a b1 at b6 with two attackers with only one defender. So the white here was obliged to capture the knight, and after it takes b6, rook e1, bishop c4 attacking the pawn, b3, bishop e6, a4, rook fd8, b4, bishop c4, trying to have a post on the c4 square to control a lot of vital points against the position of white. And after b takes c5, b takes c5, rook takes e5, attacking the bishop, but there's just simple d takes e5, f takes e5, bishop g5, and we shall see in this position now that after e5, it was very clear that the white has a pass pawn on the e-file, although the material here still even, but the white here has slight advantage with this pass pawn. And after a looking passive move that played the move g6, that is actually a blunder, in which the black here should play queen to e6, so that for example after bishop takes, rook b5 attacking this pawn and the bishop, and for example after queen to e4 with a threat to mate in 1. Again, this king, if the black will capture the c5 immediately. Bishop d5, defending. And after queen takes, bishop takes, rook takes, and the move c4. The black here successfully equalized the position after rook takes a5 with an equal material on the board. So going back after a5 g6, in which this is actually a bad move because it allows to white here to play the move queen to e4 with an attack to this bishop and a control to this diagonal, so that this pawn will actually be useful later on to promote it into a queen. So here again, Ding La Ren commit a mistake after queen e6, in which he defend his bishop instead of defending his pawn on c5. I think, for example, after this position, the black here can actually retreat his bishop and to save both his bishop and pawn. But although there is queen to d5 here, and I think the black here cannot actually hold the position with this passed pawn and this weakness on his queen side. So after queen e4, queen e6 for Ding La Ren, defending his bishop, but he actually lost his defense to his c5 pawn. And after h5, bishop d4, rook b3, rook a1 again, putting some defense to his passed pawn. And after c5, attacking the bishop. But people here just play the move a6, a good move. Because if the black here will capture this bishop, and this pawn is unstoppable to promote it into queen. So after, for example, bishop takes a6, but still there is just queen e8. And although after queen to c8, in which it actually puts to the black's position as a losing, although the black here can actually play king g7, but after bishop d5, queen b6, bishop takes b3, c6 d4, and queen takes b3, c6 d4, queen e3 check, king h1, queen takes d4. Still the black here is losing because the black here has only bishop versus the rook. So going back after queen c8, so Nipo here grab the bishop on a6 and winning a piece. And even though Ding La Ren here still continue the game after rook b8, but there's just a simple retreat of bishop to f2. And for example, if this rook capture the queen, but there is just a recapture, and again there will be a x-ray to the queen and black king on this position. So after king g7, but there's just a simple queen to d5, trying to escape from an attack, and again still have an extra piece on the board. And after rook b1 check, king h2, queen f5, and queen to e4, in which it forces some exchanges to the queen because there is a double attack to the queen and the rook. And still on this position, the white here has an extra piece on the board. So after 40 moves, Ding La Ren here resigned because he cannot afford to fight on with having a piece deficit on the board. So going back after e4, e5, knight f3, knight c6, d4, e takes d4, knight takes d4, bishop c5, we actually enter into the scratch game opening rather than a usual French move that they actually have in the game 1 and I think game 3. So here after e4, e5, we have a new opening on the e4 move, having a opening of a scratch game. And later on, after this position, in which after, for example, on this a5 move, in which the white here has a passed pawn, and after g6, in which it allows here for Nepo to be aggressive more by playing queen move and winning a pawn. And this pawn was actually converted into a piece because after queen c8, rook takes, here on this position, the white wins a piece. And after rook b8, even though they contain you, but still Dinglaren couldn't defend this position with a piece down on this position. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and please don't forget to subscribe.